guys. Today I want to do a quick look at the Cabela's 3 Forks Featherlight Waders. I opted out for the hip boots with the felt sole bottoms. They just came in the mail today, and I've been anxiously waiting for them. So let's check them out. I'm not sure if UPS or FedEx. I don't know who they use. But definitely excited. Originally, I wanted to get the LL Bean version of this. And they were $50 for a long time, and then the price shot up to $100. I guess they kind of came out with a new pair. They did some upgrades to it. I don't really think it qualifies for an extra $50, but they're $100 now, so I was not getting them. So here's our box. This is how they look. They're pretty light, which is the goal. I mean, they are called Featherweight, aren't they? The reason I got these is I want to be able to pack them. I want to be able to put them in a backpack and carry them in. Trout fishing has to be my favorite thing in the world to do. And so far, so good. And if I can pack them in and set up camp around a trout stream, that would be pretty ideal. So, these do look pretty lightweight. They look really nice. I'm pretty excited to get them on. Now, one of the reasons I went with these is because of the material. I mean, I always had like rubber hip boots. But let me see if this works. Yeah, I always had like rubber hip boots, and those things they work well. They're insulated. They keep you warm. But the problem is these things are so heavy, and these are supposed to be like a nylon pant leg, and then the inside's supposed to be coated with like a PVC. And all in all, it is really lightweight. Even the rubber they use here, this isn't the normal stuff that you see on like normal, was it Hodgman hip boots or Proline. This even seems a little bit lighter. I'm not sure how the durability is going to stand up. I did get the felt sole. I'd recommend that anyone buying hip waders always get felt sole. Pretty much common sense tells you why. They seem nice, guys. They seem real nice. Now, one thing I wanted to make sure is when I call Cabela's, and by the way, the people there were fantastic, helping me out, talking me over the phone. That's nice. How many of you guys have had rubber hip boots, and by year two, the snaps, the buckles, they dry rot and come off? I'm kind of excited about that. This is my first nylon belt loop attachment, or whatever you want to call it. But one of the requirements I had for getting these boots was how packable are they. Okay, so here's the boot again. Here's the strap connection, and it does have a Cabela's logo there. I can't get over how flexible and light this is. This is all but perfect, it seems like. But this was my goal right here. I wanted a boot that I could tuck the leg the whole way down in and pack that in. Now, I mean, I guess I could roll it up like that if I had to, but ideally, I'm going to try to pack in my backpack just like that, side by side, up and down. But you get the idea. So, I'm going to try them on, and hopefully they fit.